A couple in Illinois thought they lost a ring with enormous sentimental value forever, but now it's back thanks to the kindness of a stranger. Michelle Miller looks at the ring's 65-year, 700-mile journey.
That's probably the maker's mark.
Mike Geiger likes to find things.
These are what I use to find the treasure.
As often as five times a week, he goes out with his metal detector to comb the paths and waterways of Wisconsin in the wee hours of the morning.
Got coins from the mid-1800s. I've got jewelry from the mid-1800s.
But last week, while jet skiing on Lake Tomahawk, he stumbled upon what he calls his biggest find yet beneath 5 feet of water.
I knew right away it was a class ring, and I knew it was old just because of the style.
It was also inscribed with the initials RD, a critical clue to the ring's owner.
I know that the school has the ability to look back in their records and find the RDs in the class of 49.
He was given the phone numbers of three RDs. The first one hung up on him. The second one was 82-year-old Richard Dick Diedrich.
I explained to him that I had a ring that I thought might be his.
And my first reaction was, well, you've got to be kidding. I've never been in Waukesha, Wisconsin, where he identified being from.
Waukesha, where Geiger lives, is a two-hour drive north of Cicero, Illinois, where Diedrich grew up and graduated from J. Sterling Morton High School. When the ring vanished 65 years ago, Dick's high school sweetheart, Doris Tile, was wearing it.
We decided it might be nice that I wore her ring and she wears mine.
I had gone into the girls' washroom to wash my hands, so I took the ring off. When I turned around, it was gone.
Stolen was more like it, and then somehow ended up on the bottom of a Wisconsin lake some 350 miles away.
I never dreamt that I would get it back. That's been a real surprise and pleasure.
A pleasure, because the ring isn't just a reminder of their high school days, but a symbol of enduring love that's produced three kids and two grandchildren. That's right. Dick and Doris have been married now for 60 years.
We sometimes take votes of whether there's going to be one more.
As for Mike Geiger, no monetary reward is necessary.
It's just kind of neat that I know, you know, I gave that whole family a big piece of happiness.
I have learned there are some wonderful people out in the world, and they're willing to go out of their way to do good things.
Proving that finders aren't always keepers, and the losers, well, are sometimes the biggest winners of all. For CBS This Morning, Michelle Miller, New York.